Romney's got his own production company, you know, fax machine in the bedroom, girlfriend answering the phone, that sort of thing. Anyway, I called her, pretended I was from Channel 4, had to speak to Romney urgently. She gave me a number. This is where Romney is.
The Nebditch Intercontinental Hotel and Conference Center.
Romney asked her to book 2 double rooms. Seems reasonable to assume that one of them's for Shipley.
Can't wait.
Sharp. We will check in, but I warn you, Cambridge, I have no intention of spending the night here. If we find Shipley, I'll chat him up, we'll go through the motions, then I'm straight back to my kitchen, and Fisher can do what he likes. Sharp! Where is everybody? I mean, you'd think a place like this would be crawling with stuff, agog at the sight of actual paying customers. Hey, you better get down to reception. Someone's trying to check in.
What?
Customers in the hotel, this I gotta say.
Sir?
Morning.
Good morning, sir, madam. Welcome to Nebditch Intercontinental.
Thanks, Steve. Have another look when you've fed and watered them. Yeah. Bye.
I've just seen Giles Romney in the bar. He's on his own, but a waiter told me he checked in with another man who hasn't been out of his room in 2 days. Sir, you're right.
My hands have stopped laying.
I see. So what are you going to do about it?
Well, if they haven't started between now and Saturday night, I shall just have to go out and buy some, won't I? It's very disappointing, Cambridge. I was determined to use my own eggs on the opening night.
No, I mean about Romney.
Oh, I'll just chat him up, I suppose. So, tell me about these documentaries he makes.
They're pretty controversial. There was a famous one about nuclear waste. Then there was one about drug-taking among athletes. They both won awards.
Well, now he's making a film about DC Kenneth Shipley. Cambridge, are you telling me all you know about this?
I don't think I understand, sir.
Well, I think I'd better do this bit on my own.
Gin and tonic, please. No ice, no slice. These days, you see, they give you these sliced lemons, have you noticed? They slice these lemons in the factory, bung them in a little plastic bag, then hose them down with some sort of preservative, and Bob's your uncle, it's all for the customer's convenience. In fact, it's got more to do with their convenience, really. I mean, a fresh lemon would be most convenient for me, from my point of view. Then, of course, there's the water. I mean, all the water that comes down here is passed through everybody in this county twice over. That's why I always specify no ice, no slice.
Really?
Cheers. You're Giles Romney, aren't you?
What?
The famous filmmaker. Go on, it is you, isn't it?
Oh, God.
Hey, that one about the nuclear waste. Brilliant, brilliant.
Look, do me a favor, will you? Don't mention my name, okay? I'm, like, working on something, and it's a very delicate situation.
Hey, well, you don't have to worry about me. Absolutely stumped. So what's it about exactly?
Look, I'd rather not talk about it, okay?
Fine, fine. Nothing to do with Detective Constable Kenneth Shipley, then? Steady, steady. Another one for the gentleman.
Look, who the hell are you?
Henry Crabbe. Pleased to meet you.
Are you a policeman?
Well, sort of. Suspended, pending retirement. I got shot in the leg. Now that would make a film.
How did you find me? Nope. Don't tell me. That phone call from Channel 4. I told Tara not to talk to anybody.
Look, I'm not here officially. I just want to talk to Kenneth Shipley. People are worried, his friends, his family.
Oh, sure, tell me about it. Look, this is a man under extreme stress, but I've won his confidence. We're close, do you know what I mean? I'm the one he trusts. Okay, there are a few wrinkles that need to be ironed out, but I'm gonna make this film because it's a great story. And I want to make it for Ken's sake.
So what is the story exactly?
Why should I tell you? A lot of people would like to shut Ken up. Maybe you're one of them.
Look, if you and Shipley have evidence of criminal activity, you must report it. It's a crime to withhold evidence.
But if that criminal activity involves policemen, who do you report it to? Who do you trust?
Well, you could try me.
Got to admit, much as I love Ken, it can be pretty heavy duty.
Persuade him to talk to me, and quickly, please. This place is giving me palpitations.
Deep fried oysters on a bed of baby carrots. Good grief.
Maybe Romney will just move Shipley somewhere else.
Actually, he seemed rather relieved at being found. I think the romance of being on the run with a fugitive policeman is beginning to wear a bit thin.
Wild duck pancake in a cherry sauce. You know, this menu was written by a deeply disturbed person.
Are you ready to order, madam?
I'll just have the goat's cheese and grapefruit salad, thank you.
One Hawaiian salad. And for you, sir?
The place fillets in brandy and mustard sauce. Is there any chance I could have the place minus the sauce? Fascinating as that sounds.
No, I'm afraid that wouldn't be possible, sir.
All you've got to do is ask the chef not to put any sauce on the unfortunate fish.
The meals are pre-cooked, sir. Boil in the bag. All the chef has to do is to microwave them and snip open the bags. Even that's beyond him half the time.
Is there a problem here?
No.
There's a phone call for you.
Place Caribbean was a food, sir.
No, I think I'll give that one a miss, actually.
Phone call.
No, the place.
An excellent choice.
Thank you.
Hello? What was that you just said?
Hello, Crabbe? He'll talk to you. We're in 447. Come now. Okay, Ken. He's worried you might be wired for sound. Okay.
Ken Shipley.
Good to meet you, Clay.
Take a seat.
Well, come on, Charles. What about drink for Inspector Crabbe, huh?
Middle class. Supposed to have manners, eh? Lad of bollocks.
Vodka or vodka?
Oh, nothing for me, thanks.
We've got a real star here, Giles. This bloke's the right stuff and no mistake. Yeah, that spot of bother you had with Hooperman. Bloody joke, eh? They were trying to make out he was taking bribes from Dudley Hooperman.
No kidding.
They were dead wrong, though. I can see that now.
Can you?
When I look in a man's eyes,
I can tell whether he's honest.
I'm never wrong.
It's a gift.
It's a very handy gift for a policeman.
Yeah, look where it got me, eh? I mean, they don't want honest men in the force anymore, do they? They want blokes who are toeing the line, go with the flow. Only dead fish swim with the current. You heard that one?
Well, no, I haven't actually.
Well, I swim against the current. I go my own way. And if I think the rest are out of order, I'll say so. Why else do you think I'm still a constable at 38?
Well, this is all very fascinating, but I'm afraid I'm due back on planet Earth.
What's that supposed to mean? Is he taking a piss?
Okay, Ken, take it easy.
Look, I thought he wanted to talk to me.
He does.
Yes, I do.